I want you to know something. Opie stops me as I'm leaving tonight, and I didn't hear the end of his show.
Right.
Because I was walking in. And he goes, I want to have winter trades. And he goes, I need to make some trades. I want to trade some staff people. And I fucking said to him, and I hadn't even heard the bit, and I said, legitimately, dude, there is no one on your staff that I fucking want. Because you got a lazy staff out there. There's too many of them. They're too lazy. They'd really have to be retrained. And I go, why? Who do you want? And he goes, I want Lily, and I want Bronx Johnny. And to you guys, it's a gigantic. It's a gigantic insult. Especially to you, well, Pitsy, of all people.
Okay. Yeah, it is.
He did he did tell me in the hallway he wanted me, too.
He didn't tell me that.
He said that on the air, too. Jim said that.
He wasn't pushing for you.
No, he wasn't. He wasn't. I'm being honest. But I was.
I am willing to make fucking trades to make this thing fun. But guess what, Opie? And here's the fucking bomb I'm dropping. One of the people in this trade is Black Earl Douglas. Or there is no trade.
Wow. Yes. Sticking point.
Yes. Oh, this
non-negotiable.
Is awesome.
Great.
This is awesome.
I am trade bait.
You're not fucking trade bait. Bait would mean that brings people in. You are the fucking bomb that I stick in the bag. So that when he leaves with my money, it explodes and there's ink all over the money. That's what you are to me, Earl. For him to get Lily and Bronx Johnny, he has got to fucking take Earl. And then really, for that, I might even just go, then he owes me a Snickers bar. I really don't care much after that.
Food.
The bite size.
I'm trying to think, is there anybody I want? I would definitely want Danny on the fucking, on our team, except for Danny's fucking rampant alcoholism. I got enough problem with fucking Dave and Fez.
Right.
With alcoholism.
Yeah.
Danny didn't even make it in today.
No.
From his Super Bowl party.
I mean, that's the thing. He's the only worker they have on that staff. But the alcoholism will drag him down.
I don't think you want E-Rock.
No, that's not even way discussing.
Too sensitive. Way too sensitive.
No, he can't grab the mic. I like a guy that can grab the mic.
You wouldn't be happy with maybe a Sam?
Come on, please.
Okay. I'm just giving you options.
Sam's chick, yes. Sam, no.
That could be worked out. That could be worked out.
Do you know anybody over there that you want, Fez? You got your eye on?
I can't pick anyone out of that lineup.
How about Nathaniel Bryant?
Come on.
All right.
Fan, no.
Terrible.
What about Derek?
No.
Please.
Don't insult me.
We're down to bare bones.
I know.
Now.
It's fucking faces in the crowd at this point.
Yeah.
He doesn't. Opie lets that fucking staff come in here. That, you know what his staff looks like to me? Guys at the airport that are snowed in. You just see them laying on the floor and up against the wall.
Backpacks.
Yes.
And beards.
There's just, they have nothing to do. They have fucking dragged ONA down to, and again, Danny is the worker on the team. But I don't know if I could put up with another rampant alcoholic. And I see no reason why I should trade Dave. I don't see that.
I don't want to go. I mean, I was hoping
he didn't even
to go
bring
anywhere.
That up to me because I would have laughed at
him. Yeah, when he said it to me, I got very uncomfortable and then kind of like hid behind Fez in the thing because Fez didn't hear the whole scenario.
And Pitsy, he doesn't want you?
No, he doesn't want me.
He doesn't know you.
I hate to say it. You're fucking Derek. He's like, who? Who's Pitsy?
Pits lies all the time, too. He's like, me and Opie are homies, and Lindsay loves me. He just fucking lies, Pitsy does.
Yeah, sure. And Lindsay knows me, Opie doesn't.
Yeah, but she knows you from parties. He's paying attention to the air. You're a nice young man. No one's ever said, oh, that Pitsy's an asshole. But you do nothing to distinguish yourself on or off the air.
Well, then maybe I need to step up and do it then.
How long are you going to fucking say that to me? You would have to do it. I'm not going to fucking listen to what you say. I'm going to listen to what you do.
So am I on the trading block too then?
No, nobody wants you. You have to be wanted.
They would have to ask for you.
He came and said, I want to trade. I want Lily, who has just fucking shown on the air lately. She's fucking popping. And they want Bronx Johnny. Because he's got that great bit. He's got one bit that he could hang his fucking hat on, and that's terrific. You know, that's something that's sellable. There's a little equity there.
Pitsy's like Dale Barra in 1987. I mean, it's just, you're not going to get a lot of offers.
Am I crazy here? Do I fucking, if I throw Dave in, do I get a Jimmy Norton? I mean, why not ask? Well, all they could do is turn down.
You have every right to ask. You have every fucking right.
Listen to what a team player you are.
You know, I don't want to go anywhere, though.
What a team player.
I thought I had no trade clause, though.
No, you're heavily traded.
And no clauses.
You know what I want you to do?
It's not a clause that you have.
I want you to even take your shirt off and walk around your shorts for a couple days so they know what they're looking at. Yeah, get the shirt.
It's so good to see the New York sweatshirt gone.
Oh, I didn't even think of that. Yeah. I think we got a guest coming in, so some broads. Pull your pants up. Yeah.
Same clothes, I know. Got to bed late.
You wearing the same underwear?
Same everything, yeah, Mr. B.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, and Mr. B, my car got fucking towed away last night, so great job on my part.
And your neighborhood?
Yeah. I have to go to the pound today by like 5 o'clock and pay $185 to get my own car because of fucking ridiculous parking.
For $185, you ought to just let it go, brother.
Seen that ride.
Oh, yeah. Team player? This is the kind of shirt that I fucking wear on the Giants celebration.
Yeah, we can't put Dave up. The only one he'll ever fly in the fucking Ron Fez colors. We probably need a Ron Fez support the Giant shirt for you guys to wear tomorrow.
I'll wear this tomorrow.
Fezzy, what about you? You're an early morning guy. You're up early.
Yeah,
You like to wear dresses going O&A?
I don't want to go to the O&A show. I want to stay here with you.
Really?
Yes. Of course I do.
Think you'd be a lot...
We're peanut butter and jelly, man.
What's that?
Think you'd be a lot happier, calmer.
Would you?
Less anxious.
You think that I'm the reason for his anxiousness?
I'm not going to say all of it, but... I mean, if we're going to be, like, you know, lie detector test, honest... Definitely a percentage.
Well, why? What do I do to make him anxious?
I don't think you do anything. You're just an opposing personality.
Then why would you
Opie's
say that?
Not? Anthony's not?
They don't seem to be as frightening as you are.
There is no way I would be calmer on that show.
You're frightened of me, Fez?
No, I'm not frightened of you.
Do you think he is?
We all are.
Of me! Lovable Ron!
I love Ron!
Pitsy, you frightened of me?
A little bit, yeah.
Earl?
I'm always thinking how not to piss you off.
Why? All I ever fucking give you guys is love.
I've been honest in 3 years.
How not to... Do you think Fez is frightened of me?
No, I don't think he's frightened of you at all.
Pitsy, do you?
A tad. Yeah, a little bit.
Jesus. This is an awful thing to fucking find out about yourself. You know, I had a super Sunday, and now I'm having a really depressed Monday.
Fuck that. I mean, Michael Corleone, you know, he had underlings, and people feared him, but it didn't mean they didn't love him.
It's the Ron and Fez show.
I know. Now I'm mad that I'm getting called an underling.
Oh, no. I was talking about just me and Pitts and Earl.
Well, I don't care about you guys.
Yeah. That's just my own personal theory.
If I was to say anything, and if you fucking really believe what other people say, the intimidating factor to Fez is you. Because people think you're the one, the reason why Fez... But let me tell you, no one ever sets up a fucking thing that says how many words fucking Fez says a day and how many words Ron does. They count your words against Fez's. And supposedly, the fucking first time that he won in 6 months was the Big Tommy Z show.
Yeah.
That turned out to be a nightmare.
I mean, Fez is totally brilliant. There's no reason to be...
It's not fucking nice being known as the guy who wrote Fez. That's not a nice fucking thing to hear.
It's hard to put it on
there. No, I'm just saying Fez is he's fucking brilliant. Why would he's obviously million levels higher than me. So
then how come even in the last fucking 5 minutes you said like 900 words more than him?
Well, no, I was explaining myself with the situation. I'm just saying lie detector test. That's all, if we're going to be honest.
Well, I'm being honest, too. I think you're the intimidating factor to him.
Real? I don't.
I think you're the murderer, not me. Earl, why do you think Fez talks less?
I think a lot of it is Dave, because Dave's just so overpowering sometimes.
Thank you.
Overpowering? Thank
you. You
now, I heard this the other night. You weren't at the party, and I heard Fez was holding court and had people in tears. So I go, great, you know? And everyone goes this. Fez should have an audience all the time. And I go, that would be great if you're a stand-up comic.
Right.
But I'd put a fucking live audience in here if that's what it takes.
I wouldn't mind an audience. An audience would be cool.
Then you get it. If I was you, I'd be like, what do I got to do to fucking overpower fucking Dave? I would be thinking constantly, how do I get myself back up so that Ron and Dave stop getting blamed for fucking scaring me?
Well, I mean, Fez is an absolute genius in front of a crowd all the time, 100% of the time.
But guess what? There is more fucking people listening right now than could fill out any goddamn place you've ever been.
Right.
So picture that in your mind. That's what you have to do in fucking radio, is picture the fact that you're fucking performing live, right?
Yeah.
Now, how come I'm the only one standing up, fucking moving my hands and acting like people are paying attention to me?
Because you have that visualization.
No, I don't. I fucking am professional, and this is what I have to do for a living. I don't have some fucking natural blessing that makes me different than other humans. Everyone in fucking radio does it. Everyone in TV does it.
Okay. I do see what you're saying.
What do you think? Fucking Chris Hardball has to say, I need people there before I start yelling. Chris Hardball yells, looking directly at the camera. Here's Jeff. Jeff, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
How you doing, guys?
Good.
How about a trade of Fez, everybody on your staff, and Earl, but you keep Dave, but you get Anthony?
Is Opie ready to let that happen?
RNA, finally. A dream. A dream realized.
I know.
But RNA. Sounds awesome, too. RNA. Christ. That'd be a show.
Fucking dream team. Blind faith. It's fucking cream. You know you, Fez. You're a morning guy. Morning Fezzy. What time are you up today?
I was up at 7 today.
Guess what time I fucking went to sleep? 5:45.
That's not enough sleep.
And yet, who's fucking in here ready to perform? Who's not twirling their microphone?
Like he's fly fishing.
Yeah. You need Kathleen from the Bronx sitting next to you? Then do it.
Well, I don't think I need Kathleen from the Bronx. I like Kathleen from the Bronx.
You were in Killing the other night, right? And everybody said you were hysterical.
Right.
What's the difference?
I would say the amount of alcohol.
So you can only be funny when you're drunk?
No, I don't think so, but I think that was, you know, part of it that night.
Now, maybe I'm different. I'd be drinking on my way to work if that was the fucking situation. I'm not, I don't see where the joke is in that. Yeah. I would be fucking drinking on my way to work.
But you can also switch on that, like, drunk switch, even if you're sober. Can't, I mean, you know, if you think about acid, can't you kind of, like, get there, like, without doing it?
Hmm. Here's Rick. Rick, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, what's going on, buddies?
Yeah.
I got to tell you, oh, my God, the Ron and Anthony show, that would be a dream team. But, no, I was calling to say that, would you be willing to give up Lily to get rid of Earl and not get anything in return?
I really hate the idea of losing Lily. I mean, I really fucking feel Lily's on the cusp right now. And by the way, she lost and is basically a love slave for Aunt Melinda. She lost flat out. That was a bet she put out there herself. Did we pull that audio?
No, not yet.
I wonder if I was a producer, I would think that's the kind of stuff that producing is. I would wonder if that, but I'd be up in the morning going, what audio could I pull? I'd even be thinking, hey, could I pull anything from last night's show?
Right.
I would wonder if that would be the things that would be on my mind.
Yeah.
Don't anyone move.
Should
I
would
stay exactly where they are. No, freeze, Pitsy. I want you to freeze. Just sit around and ponder with me. We'll all ponder together.
So Lily has to spend the night with Anthony and Melinda now.
Now, I don't think I want to lose Lily from the show.
I wouldn't. I think she's a unique female voice.
Yeah, she's good.
That's not, you know, heard on radio.
Bronx Johnny isn't even here enough to worry about. And plus, I mean, he comes in, what, once a week, once every 2 weeks? Does his gimmick and walks out?
Yeah. Well, yeah, once every 2 weeks.
And, I mean, he's just going crazy acting out like he's going to marry this girl. Which, guess what? Ain't going to happen. That's Ecuadorian fucking bullshit talk. That's crazy talk. Paula will get married. That's a guarantee. Well, who would you trade for, Fez? What would be the trade? You're executive producer.
Yeah, but, I mean, I don't know of anyone on the ONA staff that I would want to trade for. I go through every one of them in my mind.
What, was Opie pissed at those guys today? Because I know it happened at the end of their show and I was walking in.
There was dissension on the staff.
What's going on? Give me the details.
E-Rock got passed over for a raise and a promotion. And Danny got named senior producer, so E-Rock was upset about it.
And well, then, see, Danny's the fucking guy.
Yeah, and then some of the guys started in on Eric, like Travis. Sam saying that he's overrated.
They hate him because he's the apple in Opie's eyes.
That's a possibility.
Yeah.
So when Opie heard all the dissension and the staff wasn't going to get along, didn't sound like they were going to be able to get along.
Right.
He started talking blockbuster trade talk.
If I was a producer, I'd be pulling that stuff so we could listen and go over it. I need information to be able to make these moves. So they definitely, obviously, making this move, they want to keep Danny. And that was the only one that I said I was interested in. Now, why wouldn't even someone said, hey, Ron, he just got made senior producer, and he's the reason why this all is happening anyway.
Oh, I'm not sure if Danny's untradeable. I am not sure about that at all. If you put together a sweet package, I think Danny could go on the block.
Tina. Tina, you're on Ron and Fez.
They want to give you E-Rock.
See, here's the thing. I know for a fact that E-Rock's even said to other people, I don't think Ron likes me. I try to be nice to Ron. He's always gruff. I can't be around fucking that kind of sensitivity.
Right.
You know?
I understand.
And even Danny's a little too sensitive with that.
But that's what the trade talk was, is they want to give you E-Rock because they want to get him off there for the dissension factor.
Would I trade E-Rock for Earl? Because I'm not trading Lily. There's no fucking sense in it. Yes, I'm going to, you know, let Anthony have her for the night. That's a legitimate bet. There's nothing I can do about that. Mm-hmm. She's going to come back. I'm going to feel like when she comes back to me, I'm just going to walk up to her, take a handkerchief, and just wipe her face clean with it. I might even chase her as Anthony's helicopter comes away. No! No!
I think that'd be a good trade.
I actually...
E-Rock for Earl? I think that'd be good.
I tried to talk Bob Eatman into taking Lily and teaming him up with, you know, some guy and doing morning radio somewhere. I think she's fantastic.
Yeah.
I think she's really strong. So they... Basically, they want to get rid of E-Rock.
He is the dissension factor as of today.
And Earl, you're the worst thing we have.
I don't want to be trading. Number one, I'm not saying I love you guys. I love the you
love ONA too, though.
I love them both. I love both shows equally. But you've always given me a fair shake.
What's that, Dave?
How dare you disrespect this? That is radio not,
it
program.
Wasn't meant as disrespect. I mean,
the Ron Fez show.
I love.
That's where we get fucking paid.
But you. First of all, you wouldn't let
you don't love shit equally.
But you won't
this program above anything
but
else.
You gotta let me finish. Please let me. But I love the fact you guys gave me the shot when no one was giving me a shot.
Yeah, so then why would you love them equally?
When Opie hired 19 people and wouldn't take you. And I'm not even fucking making that up, bro. He hired 19 people and didn't have a spot for you. And yet you say, I love them equally. You should go to them.
That's crazy, man.
And then I hope the first day they make you ski. I hope that's the first thing they do. And by the way, this was my favorite line that Anthony had out of a million yesterday when he says to Dave, Randy Bennington said, Randy Bennington said. That was my favorite fucking line. I felt like I got shot. That was so funny. That motherfucker is so funny.
Oh, man. That was the best.
Doesn't always remember you like when there was a kid from like another neighborhood who would come on your court and everybody's game would just come up. You're like, yeah, I'm fucking playing too.
Oh, when you guys were talking to Kathleen, I really was very close to pissing myself for real. Not like in a, you know, for real.
Here's Kenny. Kenny, you're on Run Fest.
Carrie?
Hey, Carrie.
Say, Jimmy was willing just to take Lily's scarf. So you can keep Lily. Just give him a scarf.
Jimmy's got a Lily thing, and I don't blame him for it. I don't blame him for that at all. And she is totally frightened of him. And we might not even get her back, knowing that that she owes herself to Anthony and Melinda. The only thing that is there's some kind of gypsy honor in that fucking Albanian family of hers that I think she's going to go do the right thing.
But we won't get her back unchanged. I think it'll be a different Lily that comes back to us.
Probably gum chewing. No. I'm going to imagine gum chewing.
See ya.
All right, peace. Here's Mike. Mike, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ron, how's it going?
Good.
Hey, I think you're missing the diamond in the rough there, Ronnie, is you need to give Melinda. You need to sexy that show up.
I would Melinda. Take Melinda in a heartbeat, but to break up the Lockhorns, I don't know. I don't know. If we had Melinda in here, we would know everything about Anthony. There would be no secrets.
We get something new every day.
According to her.
According to Melinda.
Johnny Denver.
Here's Tom. Tom, you're on Run Fez.
Hey, buddies. Congratulations to the art. I think we love the team as it is out here, warts and all. I mean, change is good sometimes, but guys, you do have a winning combination.
No, this show's broken. This may be...
We love it.
Quite frankly, this has got to be the worst show I've ever heard.
No,
I can't speak for anyone else.
No.
It's a pretty awful show.
No. I equate
and
this.
I found out what the problem is today. I'm Earl Weaver, and I frightened everybody.
He won. Hey, Earl Weaver won a couple championships. You know?
I'm a guy who smokes in the dugout myself. I understand completely.
He's a Hall of Famer. I compare this team to the 2007 and 2008 Giants. You know? There's some problems, but I think we pull together. I used to believe
who's
that.
Who's our Tiki Barber? Who's our bald-headed black guy?
You know who he is.
Who has no loyalty.
You know.
Earl, if anything happens in this trade, you're going, brother. If the trade happens, part of the deal will be they have got to take you.
I mean, I do not want to leave.
You love them equally. What's the problem?
You won't notice the difference.
I want that fucking alarm of yours going off quarter after four, Earl. I would love it. I'd love to see you doing Honest Day.
And again, you took my words completely out of...
No, that was a direct quote.
Could you see the look in those faces of K-Rock and CBS when they saw fucking Earl once again like a ghost in those hallways wandering around doing nothing?
Earl would be late 4 out of 5 days in a work week.
Earl would be relieved beyond belief, I think, because Steve would be doing a lot of the Earl stuff.
Believe me, there's no work to do on the O&A show. I see those guys. They're waiting to see when their plane is finally fucking rerouted. They've got the laziest staff I've ever seen in my life. The largest, laziest staff I've ever seen. That fucking looks like hole in the wall after a big fucking after a big fucking kill where everybody's just sitting around. So you're going, Earl, if any deal gets done.
I don't want to go, and I can't believe I'm sort of I'm the guarantee.
How could you not believe it, Earl? I've been telling you for a year and a half.
Earl Judas.
You're a player to be named sooner.
Who do I want? I definitely... See, this is... They say it's a trade, but it's just another excuse to get rid of E-Rock. Why would I even fall for this?
That's exactly what it is. There's one common denominator of dissension there, and it's E-Rock.
Well, we've got five different dissensions here. And how's E-Rock going to do with me? Somebody who's going to expect him to do work?
Not well.
How quick before he's in tears with me? If those guys get him upset.
That's true, but...
He doesn't have one buddy on that show?
No, I don't think so. For real.
Yeah.
I like E-Rock.
Me too. I don't like him, but yeah. I do.
I'm friends with all those guys.
But let me just say this. I have a certain spy that comes back and tells me what people say.
I know what you're saying.
Hmm. And he supposedly told people, I don't think Ron likes me. You know. What am I going to do? Talk when I'm not on the air? Grab a mic if you want to talk. I don't want to chat about things when I'm not getting paid for it. It's like fucking losing money. It's like being a bricklayer and sitting around fucking laying brick after fucking work. Why would you do it?
Who do you think is more trustworthy, E-Rock or Earl? And here's why. Earl, we know, is a pathological liar.
Right.
But E-Rock does seem to ask a lot of questions and is nosy. So who would you trust more?
E-Rock's definitely a bigger gossip. But don't you feel like he's loyal to Opie?
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean?
Like, yeah, I do.
Very much,
and,
yeah.
If I have that, I mean, if I have loyalty, it means everything to me. Where I don't know if Earl's loyal to me.
Not after today's comments.
The problem with E-Rock on the ONA show is, like, the staff all kind of teamed up and formed alliances. Than and Sam got together. Danny and Steve are pals. And E-Rock ends up as the unattractive girl sitting out during the dance.
Well, that's because he does have a chick in his life, though.
Yeah.
Attractive, too.
Actually, all those guys got attractive chicks. Yeah. That's one thing you'd say. And they all owe that to ONA. Because they wouldn't fucking be getting them on their own in the streets.
No. Not at all. Ugly pieces of garbage, although I can't really talk much.
Hey, enjoy. You got it. You did it. It worked for you.
They're not a good-looking bunch, though. You're right.
Who do you think is more attractive, staff?
I'll tell you, if it was up to me right now, well, first of all, nobody's better looking than Hicks. But
thank you.
This would be a dream of mine. Earl's out, and Hicks moves up into that fucking position.
Oh, I want that real bad. I want a paycheck.
But here's my problem.
Okay.
You have dreams of your own show. And I think when that happens to you, you got to chase those. Because, like, when I had J-Dubs working with me, it never felt permanent because he wanted his own show. And I respected it, and I always treated him, you know, like a peer. I never yelled at him and shit. And I don't yell at you because I feel like, well, you want to be in the fucking, you know, you want to be on mic.
Yeah, but I think I could add a lot as producer to a Ron and Fez show.
But it would be a temporary thing. I try to think every time somebody comes on, are they going to be with us forever?
Oh, that was my goal.
Mm-hmm.
You asked me what's my five-year plan or something.
And we owe you back. Fezzy knows this. And Fezzy's on the fucking job for you.
Oh, I don't want anything from you guys. I mean...
Okay, well then that's what you're going to get.
No, that made that easier.
That's also a business.
No, but when I interview with you guys in 5 years, I was saying hopefully in 5 years I'm with the Ron Fez radio program.
He did say that. Where Earl didn't. He goes, hopefully Muni comes back to life.
Oh, I did not wish Muni back.
In 5 years, you think they're going to discover that technology, Earl?
And the thing about Pitsy, and I blame this on you, Earl, because you were executive producer on the time, is just he's got no place to go. He's got no motivation. And Fez, you're the new executive producer. You haven't lit a fucking light under him. I mean, he sat in here yesterday for 5 hours and maybe said two lines.
Right. And they were one-worders.
Yeah.
Yes, Ron.
You will never hear Pitsy's keeping Fez off the air.
Pitsy likes the administrative work, you know, unfortunately.
Does he?
Yeah.
Well, let's give him some. Let's keep him fucking busy. Is this guest fucking canceled, Earl?
We're finding that out now.
Guess what? I would think canceled.
Yeah, Pitsy's on the phone now.
30 minutes later? Why am I here today instead of running that fucking best stuff?
Because of the guest.
Trade him.
You're right, Dave. You're the only one I can trust. I know I can't trust E-Rock.
But less
I really like his chick, though.
So I. But yeah. Less trustworthy than Earl?
I didn't want to give out her name.
What if we trade for E-Rock, and then E-Rock's not allowed to talk to you personally? Anything that E-Rock...
No, I don't have a problem with him. He's the one who whines about me.
I'm saying, yeah, to protect his sensitivity, if he has anything
I don't
want
to protect people's sensitivity.
Okay.
Stop being so fucking sensitive around me. How come you guys can't act like fucking guys? Just be a regular fucking guy.
You have no plans on like a butcher? He's a part of the ONA staff.
I have no idea who he is.
he's a
Which
guy,
one is he?
He runs the board. I think him for Earl might not be so bad. He's a young guy.
Hey, Ethan, you're on Fez.
Hey, Ronnie. Hey, Fezzy. Hey, Dave and Earl. Is Bronx Johnny out of the trading pool? Because I know Opie has sung his praises before.
Opie loves that bit. And there's no reason that he shouldn't. Bronx Johnny's actually a pretty good on-air character, but he's got no energy. He doesn't... he's got no real ambition. And then I hear him on... the little show that he does with Hicks, and I think he sounds terrific on there.
Yeah.
You know, he wants his own show, period. Yeah. That's what he wants. What he really wants is his own after show. He wants to have the party that happens after the show. Pitsy, what's going on with Earl?
He's making that phone call to our guest.
Now, why didn't you make it?
I just got the number, and he said he would call.
I'd like to shut it down, if it's up to me. A fucking half hour late.
All right, I'll pass that to Earl.
For somebody who's not on fucking, you know, I don't want to run down in case we got to do the thing because it's a nice little show, but, you know, I felt like I was doing a nice thing.
And Earl lied to you.
Why is that?
He said Pitsy was making the phone call. Pitsy was not making the phone call. He was.
I was on the phone with CTB, Dave.
Taking care of business?
I'm defending you. Stupid.
Yeah, but he doesn't want to fucking... He doesn't understand that. Fezzy, I would never fucking yell at you, and now I understand you hate me and you're scared of me, but...
I don't hate you or scared of you.
You took the executive producer job, right?
Right.
The team is not running any better than it did under Earl.
It was a complete bomb.
Total failure. What are we going to do? Have Dave talk more?
No.
Is that your way out of this? More Dave talking?
No.
Look how upset
please,
you get.
Please not. We love Fez. The whole staff loves Fez. I think you gotta get rid of Earl Dougie.
Mike, you're in front of Fez.
Hey, Ronnie, what's going on?
Good.
Hey, do we really think, though, behind the scenes that O&A are going to give us a choice? I mean, do we really have a say?
Oh, absolutely. What happens here is I wasn't looking to move anybody, but, you know, everything's for sale, as they say in this world. And right now, O&A are in a desperate situation.
Yeah, that's true.
But there's only a couple of assets that they have that we're interested in. And they have an awful staff. And I can't say enough fucking good things about O&A and Jimmy. But they did not train a staff. They asked these people of nothing. They want nothing from these kids other than to fucking suck money out of the fucking show. That's what these kids do. And I won't even let our staff talk to them. If I see Lily talking to them, I go, I don't want you picking up their bad habits. Stay away from them.
Right.
And Fezzy, you're gonna fucking drop Sam like a bad habit on Friday, right?
Friday, Sam goes down. It's wrestling trivia. Me against this upstart, Sam, from Sam and Than. He doesn't stand a chance against me. And loser has to walk around the block here in Manhattan dressed as the WWE legend Goldust.
Fez is going to kill him.
Well, since Fez just took the collar to Z-Man, and I get a fucking email from Z-Man today that if any of you guys saw it, you would be furious. And what can you do? The guy's the winner. Our team lost on that one. And now he's getting on the air here. Ronnie, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Yeah, I was going to say, next time Opie's bitching about E-Rock, say, look, dude, I got fucking Earl. What the fuck are you crying about? Maybe he's a little spoiled, but you should definitely keep Danny, get Hicks, and run you and Fez, and that's the show. And give him the Rider.
The Midnight Rider.
Some people are just angry about this instead of seeing it as opportunity. Just furious. Here is Sean. Sean, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ronnie. My suggestion would be to get rid of Earl, and I think it would be a good move to put Dave into the executive producer position because he would have more work to do. I think he has really no loyalties to any of the other staff except for you, and that would make him push the staff harder and talk less so that Fez could get in there more.
I actually am, I think, a pretty loyal person, but...
You're 100% loyal.
I mean, I've about Pepper and stuff, you know, I've even talked with Don, you know, just, I mean, I'm pretty loyal.
You're pretty loyal, but you are not an administrative guy.
No, I agree with that.
I mean, you're a fucking train wreck, yeah. Which to me makes you really fun and good on the air. I mean, I would be a terrible fucking executive producer. I'd be awful at it. So I don't have any problems acting like I'm not, you know... Able, I need somebody who fucking wants to do stuff,
right.
And who cares. I want somebody who doesn't have a fucking look like they're fucking locked into like they got a fucking deer in the headlights.
Some people really.
Hey, what
like
do we do
work?
With that caramel corn from yesterday?
We still have the caramel corn. The caramel corn's here.
I like to have a nice little cup of that. That's the world's best fucking caramel corn.
That's the Garrett's.
I fucking say it to Brother Joe and I think Beth, and they're like. I go, this is the best caramel corn in the whole fucking world. And Joe's like, oh, does it have peanuts in it? No, then it ain't good, right? Then later he's like this. I want to say something. You know, I really apologize. That fucking caramel corn's amazing.
I'm glad he came around on it.
And I never give Chicago any fucking props. First of all, their pizza's too fucking thick. And then second of all, they go to baseball games and don't really pay attention. And then worst of all, they're stealing Deb from us. But in this case, they have some fantastic caramel corn. Here's Wayne. Wayne, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, how's it doing, guys? Great show last night. Ronnie, could you handle E-Rock coming in at 11:30 every day?
I tell you, I'd fucking just snap a knot in that shit. I cannot fucking put up with it. My thing to the staff is they should be working harder than me. They should be bringing me fucking stuff.
Mm-hmm.
A-Rock, notoriously late, has trouble making it into the show consistently.
But is that so dissimilar from Earl Douglas?
You hate Earl.
I don't hate him. But after today, actually, we were really getting along quite well. But after today's show, where he said he doesn't like you guys, basically, to me.
Hmm.
He said he likes O&A just as much as you. O&A don't send
a paycheck. But he knew them for years before he knew us. And I mean, I know he loves those guys.
I mean, they're lovable people, but you work for a show. You can't.
Let's face it.
Cheater can't say I fucking love the Red Sox all of a sudden.
Let's face it. We were forced to take fucking Earl when we came here. Now it wasn't like you have to take Earl, but Opie's like, you guys are coming in. I put in a good word with you with Elo. Hey, if you think there's an opportunity, and I'm not making you, but could you take Earl? And I swear to God, that's 100% shoot. I'm trying to get out of fucking JFK. I'm like, of course. I love Earl. In the back of my mind thinking, you fucking got me, Opie. You fucking got me.
Oh, that was just something else.
Mm. All right, let's break here. Ron and Fez show.
It's the Ron and Fez Show on XM 202.
What happened?
I gotta say, the chemistry is a little weird here. I think we need a blockbuster trade.
Really?
I say we go blockbuster trade with Ron and Fez.
Hmm.
Blockbuster trade.
Well, who would we have to trade off to
everyone
alleviate?
For Lily?
That's what we gotta figure out. Blockbuster trade time.
Well, it seems that the it seems like the common denominator in the friction is E-Rock. Like, if you get rid of E-Rock, you pretty much solve the problem amongst everybody else, because it's all...
But that's what the Knicks are saying about Stephon Marbury, but
yeah.
Then they're thinking he's like the franchise. You know, D-Rock likes to think of himself as like the LeBron James of the Opie and Anthony show, so...
Hmm. Think like a...
So you're thinking
maybe
E-Rock.
Maybe East Side Dave?
Well, I don't E-Rock. Know. I don't know. Like, blockbuster trades, you got to sit down and think it over and see what makes sense.
See, I think if you lose E-Rock, then you'd have to divvy up his responsibilities. And that includes all the stuff that he's doing after the show.
Yeah, I've let it be known that I really want Bronx Johnny. So I think it's time to like figure out a trade.
Bronx Johnny, maybe. Yeah, he's really good.
Oh, yeah, I want Bronx Johnny.
You can see there that Anthony definitely wants Dave, because he knows. But, of course, Opie has a Bronx Johnny thing.
Yeah.
He certainly does.
Don't understand that, but...
Well, it's the one bit. That bit's very powerful, and, you know, Opie comes out of radio. You're always looking for a hit. You're always looking for a hit, not whether you like it or not.
That's true.
So E-Rock is the only one they really want to launch. They want to get rid of E-Rock.
Yeah. So you're going to have to come up with maybe a Pitts or Earl package.
They don't want Pitts or Earl. They want something that they can get on the air. They're looking for... one of our air characters.
You heard what they wanted. They mentioned Lily, they mentioned Dave, they mentioned Bronx Johnny.
Yeah, they want somebody that can give them a little pop every once in a while. What do you think of E-Rock overall?
He seems like a friendly person. But
as a worker, I know a lot of friendly people.
As a worker?
You know, Stalker Patty's friendly. I don't want her in here every day.
As a worker, I think he's good. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I do. I do.
Fez?
I think he's a panic, you know, person, where, like, if the heat's really on, he's gonna fall down on the job.
Who does that remind me of? Let me try to think.
Trust me, I'm speaking from what I know.
He does do a lot of...
Is he a panicker?
Yeah, he does. He does get nervous, but...
All I know is he told people he doesn't think I like him.
Right.
That's all I really know of him.
And
I've always felt like I like him. And his dad sent me some fantastic cigars. All right, let me bring Hicks in. Hicks, you're the only one I can trust.
Oh.
Give me the E-Rock situation.
Well,
give me the lowdown.
Besides Danny, E-Rock's the only one I see really working. Like, he's here
really?
A lot of the time. He's here late.
Mm.
Like, he's here like 3, 4 o'clock.
But you're lining up a lot of things that go along with Earl. He's here all hours. He is he's very much a hypochondriac.
So far you've compared him to yourself and Earl, which is frightening to me. I would like to have a guy on the show.
Well, he's not very manly, if that's what you're looking for. In fact, much of their staff is
somewhat
effeminate. Feminine, to say the least.
Here's Scott. Scott, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, they didn't let that bit run a little farther. They talked about E-Rock, but then all of a sudden they switched it. They want to get rid of... They were talking about giving you Sam because he's on your show a lot.
Yeah, and he does very well with us, as a matter of fact.
Mm-hmm.
He does very well. Now, does he do work off the air? That's the question.
No.
Because I ask him flat out, and he's like, I pull tape. What is that?
Yeah. I've seen him with a camera once.
And he runs the video camera.
Why?
Exactly.
For so what? A movie's coming out I don't know about?
There's no spot for that.
No, he's a
smart
guy.
On either show.
He's a smart guy. Off the air, you know?
If I took Sam, I'd have to have Than. I can't break them up.
What about a Sam Than E-Rock package for Earl and Pitts?
They don't want Pitts. Pitts, no offense to you, but you're fucking a no-name. You're not even, I wouldn't even say triple. I'd say you're fucking double-A ball right now to most people.
What if you throw in a Johnny, then? A Sam Than and E-Rock for
so
Earl
you're saying
Pitts
this,
and Johnny.
This gives me the opportunity to get rid of fucking Pitsy and have a little fucking cash. You know what I mean? Then later, to move in a Hicks, who really, let's face it, wants his own show.
I mean, the struggle is you're going to have to give up someone, you know, good, and that would be Johnny, but you...
I'm more than willing to give up Johnny because he's never here.
Okay? Yeah, that's,
and
you
he's,
know.
You know, been hanging around for fucking, what, 2 years?
Yeah.
With still, you know, still not showing anything that he wants to do other than that show of his.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm willing to put Johnny up. I don't want to lose Lily.
No, you can't do that. She's the only feminine voice in 202, and she's original.
Well, there's another one. I do a show.
Hell.
Someone I know.
Lily was the first name Ropey mentioned.
Mr. C mentioned my name, but I just like to say, as much as I love you, Mr. C, I can't part with Mr. W's and Mr. B's.
Nah, that's loyalty.
Can't do it. But I love
in the meantime, I like Hicks.
Love him.
Hicks is like, I'll go anywhere. I don't give a shit. Well, let me ask you this. Would I want Sam and Than? That might make E-Rock's life easier for them. And I will give them Bronx, Johnny, and Earl.
Yeah. I think you make that deal. I think you do. You know, that's...
That sounds good.
You're getting a lot, I think, a lot of quality there.
Would I do this? Throw Pitsy just into the fucking mix?
Yeah, get rid of
and not Pitsy, you might look like a superstar over there, because they have a staff that doesn't work. You could be one of those fucking faceless guys that's, you know, collecting tape and running boards and stuff.
You throw Pitsy in, it's going to look good on paper.
You'll be one of those people I call Buddy. And then you fucking... You free up a little thing here. We can get some of the real workers on the air.
Well, if I gotta go, I gotta go. I would want to stay here, but if you
no
know,
trade clause,
he do you
bring,
see
he
the
doesn't
difference?
Bring up the no trade clause. He jumped right in.
Dave started crying and clawed not to go out the door. You're like, hey, if I gotta go, I gotta go. That's why I fucking no fucking offense, kid, but I said, why do you want? I go, you got one open spot. Why is this kid Pitsy? Well, he's been here. He's loyal. I go, he doesn't put anything on the air. And so people at home don't care one way or another. He's loyal. And these fucking three guys stood for you. And to this day, they still can't figure out why. Friendship is what it always comes down to. That's the way Fez executive produces. Friendship. It's not a business to him. And we pay for it.
Yeah. It's interesting what comes out in these trade talks, though.
Why? That's been there all the time. There's nothing new. You fucking think, Fezzy, is you learn the same thing every day. Every day you're like, oh, yeah, I should do that. Build on the Fez character. You're right. Next day, what's wrong? Is this a little tense? You build on the Fez character? No. But that's a good idea. Build on the Fez character. Like fucking Groundhog's Day around here. That's a possibility.
Yeah.
Because we just don't want E-Rock.
No.
We do not want him.
No. No. I mean, that's decided.
Yeah. I just got a thing sent to me from HTG. Don't take E-Rock. He's lazy and shiftless. All right. Thanks, you, HTG.
Well, you know, she does know him well.
She's going to be honest with me, too.
Yeah. She's a straight shooter, so that's some surprising info.
Thank God for that.
And with Than, we at least get someone who can play piano at parties.
It's true. Although I can play some keyboards for you.
You can?
Yeah. I've never played you some of my songs.
No, you haven't.
Never. We've never heard your music.
There's a keyboard here?
I think Than has one.
Dwayne, you're on Run of Fez.
Ball, fellas.
Yeah.
How about trading Bronx Johnny for Roland? You know, keep Dave there to make it for some interesting radio, watching him beat Dave's ass all the time. That'd be funny.
Here's Joe. Joe, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yo, buddy.
Yeah.
I really think that, I think Than would be the golden pickup in this trade.
Than?
That's my feeling.
I like the Sam and Than combo. My problem is the same as Hicks. They have dreams of being on the air. Unlike Hicks, they're not going to make it. Hicks is going to get his own show one day. Sam and them, it's never going to happen.
I think the best question that you always ask people is, what's your five-year plan?
Yeah.
And then you should know. We asked Pitsy that. Pitsy wanted to be a top chef somewhere.
Oh, that's right.
That should have been the first clue.
You make me dislike Pitsy more and more every fucking second.
You always have my back. Thanks, Dave.
No, come on. I do, but you know.
Dave, I didn't know your five-year plan included keyboards.
Let's hear. Are you all set up here?
Yeah.
Come around the park, and we go around the park, and the doggy goes bark, and we go around the park. It's time to go to the park.
Some, like, kind of that type of deal. But I can actually play
very well.
Did
you write that yourself?
Yeah. But, I mean, it's better without words.
Mm.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
And then this one.
So is this all your songs are just like scales?
No. This one I call Raindrops, which is, you're really going to like this one.
Okay. You're right. I really do like Raindrops. So it's really good.
Those are some of my tunes.
Yeah. Here is Ryan. Ryan, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, buddies.
Yeah.
Why don't you trade Pitsy for a toaster or a gift card or something like that?
A toaster? They're not going to give up their toaster.
Same shape.
Here's Bone, you're on Run of Fez. How are you? Hi, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
Dave, I'm impressed with your piano playing, but I think it could use just a little cowbell.
All right, thanks. And you wonder why we don't do pyramids. Let's hear a little more of your piano playing, would you, Dave? It's very nice. What do you call that one?
I call that toothpick.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I could actually play some hits if you'd like.
Sure.
I'd like to teach the world to sing and furnish it with love.
It's fun. It's a real nice sing-along for everybody. What was that, by the way?
That was I'd like to teach the world to sing.
Mm.
And then you have the...
That's the Coca-Cola song? That's the hit you're playing?
Was that what it was from?
Yeah.
We learned it in grade school when I was like...
They should have gave you a Coke with it.
They told us it was like a Catholic song.
Sure. Yeah, it's Catholics. Because they're the second biggest organization in the world. Catechism and Coke. All right, getting something else?
This is just for the holidays.
Nice.
Like Schroeder on Charlie Brown.
And then this is a one that, this is another original composition. Shit. I fucked it up. Hold on.
No. Hey.
That's called Olden Time.
Do the Mess Around. Why don't you play that for us? Little Ray Charles. Do the Mess Around.
We do the mess around. I don't know that song. What?
Go ahead and play it.
We do the mess around.
You know what? Your problem is you got to play along with the song.
Okay.
That's what you got to do. Yeah, we got no more listeners, so we're done. Oh. I guess we're done for the day then. I have a thing on XM where I can see where the last listener finally turns off the radio, and that was it.
Gotta learn that.
So, maybe we'll stay on in case anybody else stays in here. But anyway, I thought it was good. I just saw just a tremendous dropout.
Really?
I can always. And normally, when you're talking, there's a drop off.
Yeah, I know.
But when you're
like.
Wait, another guy just come in, so act like we're doing the show. All right, there you go. He just left. All right, so I don't know. What do you guys want to do tomorrow? What we might? I'm just going to stay in case another listener comes back.
Oh, okay.
But as of right now, we are empty. There's no one listening next time.
Shit.
Well, you know what I
didn't
think?
Know that song.
Well, you know what? We tried something. We tried to improvise.
Yeah.
It didn't work out for us. We were doing the mess around. You know.
Right,
we did the mess around. We're doing a crazy mess around.
Just like,
gotta pick it up.
We're doing the mess around. Hey, let's go all over town.
Oh, here we go.
Mess around. We mess around. All over town.
All right, hold on. Wait, I'm getting really, really suicidal.
Uh-oh.
Let me try to shake this. I feel like I'm going to kill myself now.
Yeah, let's do a timeout then there.
Don't have the sheet music or anything, though. That's the thing. I mean.
All right, I think it's passing. I almost dove out the window.
Better now?
Uh-uh.
Oh.
Because I'm, you know, sometimes I remember what it sounded like to hear that.
Right.
It just makes me still want to kill myself.
That'll stick in there. Earworm.
I mean, I don't really know the song, so I was.
Messing around.
Earl, do we want Sam and Than on our show?
No, I wouldn't want Sam and Than on the show.
Why not?
No, because I think I just don't get the whole, like, you know, the one guy's kind of the wise guy and talks like this, and then the other one's just really dry like that.
Mm. Look at the impressions.
What, do you like the same person to be doing the show together?
No, it's just, I don't know. It's just,
you like a show with twins?
I don't like a show with twins either.
Who would you want from that show? If you had to pick one.
If I had to pick one, I would take Danny.
All right, then Danny's in and you're out.
What?
Thank you, Earl.
I don't want to be out.
Earl, you made that very easy.
Justin, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, yeah, I was just calling to see if, I'm not listening right now, but is David done playing the piano?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to turn it back.
Yeah, come on back. I've noticed that some people have come back since they stopped.
Again,
and what I'll do, I'll see if we can't empty the room again. Whenever we get a bad caller, here's what we'll do. Any bad caller, you get to mess around.
All right, good.
Right out the door.
And I will punish you, pricks. I will punish you, pricks. Scooter. Scooter, you're on Run of Fez.
Hi, Mr. Bennington. Hi, Mr. Wally. How are y'all doing?
Nice to talk to Scooter. Where are you calling from, Scooter?
I'm a trucker. Right now I'm in Illinois. Going to the fog.
What are you hauling today, Scooter?
Today I'm actually hauling taco shells.
And how far before you got to go before you get there?
Let's go!
Oh, no.
Come on! Let's mess around.
Woo! Messing around again.
All right, stop.
Come on, go!
He's going to something. I'll switch off. You know how to turn on that thing, Earl? You know how to hit it?
Yes.
Wouldn't that be great if you did that? Let me go over here to Brian. Brian, you're on my Fez.
Hi, Ronnie. First of all, as a trucker, let me tell you how much I enjoyed the coverage yesterday of the bowl game as you guys saw it.
Oh, thank you so much. It was so much fun to do.
And it sounded like it. Now, Ronnie, I don't know what your favorite cigars are. I don't care. I make enough money that I can afford to send you a case a month if you...
Let's go! With the mess around!
Playing
Hello!
Again.
Oh, we go!
He's gone. Mm-hmm. He's gone. You don't even know the words, will you?
No.
You jump into the hook.
I don't have the sheet music.
Yes, but you can hear that he's not at the mess around part. When you're yelling, let's go. The mess around.
I'm going to...
Enthusiasm.
Wish someone would hand me the thing.
Hey, David. David, you're on Run of Fez.
Ronnie.
Yeah.
Hey, I got to put out the irony here. Earl doesn't think the Than and Sam show works because one guy talks funny and the other one's a smartass. What does that sound like to you?
Does it sound a little like the Ron and Fez show?
A little bit.
He gets his digs in, doesn't he?
Yeah.
I mean, calling Fez funny looking is weird, though.
Mike, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Sounding.
Hey, I'm not listening anymore. I couldn't take any more Dave, but I want to know, is this the number I call to cancel my XM?
Where are you calling from, really, Mike?
Albany.
Oh, you know what? I've got two friends that are moving to Albany. What is it like to live up there?
It sucks.
Does it really? Is it awful?
Yeah, there's not shit to do up here.
Is at least, how far are you from Canada?
About 3.5 hours from Montreal.
Let's go! Yeah. Earl, what did you do? Jump in that time? Or you just pick it up from any place that you're at?
I was picking up at the vocal.
Is the bit have some kind of a consistency that thing starts up?
Yes.
Is that the funny part?
Yeah.
Mm. But so why jump ahead?
That was my fault. Absolutely my fault.
Yes. That's why I'm asking you about it. You know what? I think I'm going to put Than in your seat. I'm not sure yet. And you're going to be up at 4:15. No matter what deal comes down, Earl's got to go. I'd love to get Pitsy on the thing. I think they might end up keeping Pitsy. Because next to their workers, he's going to look like he gets things done.
He's busy.
So Ron and Fez show. Big, Super Tuesday tomorrow. Fez, even though you're voting Obama, you still feel like you can't win now. You feel like it's over.
Yeah, I feel like tomorrow Hillary is just going to lock it up. You know, and they said that, you know, a lot of these states are close. I think when it all ends up, I think Hillary breaks away, especially tomorrow. 22 states.
What do you think has happened, though? Why did that happen?
You know what? I think it's just New Hampshire all over again. Where it's like, it looked like Obama had a better chance than he actually did.
You haven't bought into the hope thing, have you?
No, I haven't. No, I think we're going to go with an establishment candidate, Hillary Clinton.
Earl, how could you shake me off when I know I gave it to you?
You did give it to me, and I loaded it. I can't find the freaking thing.
Okay. Well, why don't you take over for here then? Because I don't want to do this anymore.
It's the last thing I did before I left.
And then what was the other thing? Fucking having me come in to do this fucking guest who's on fucking Stars Network? A fucking network 90% of the people don't even get?
Yeah, I understand. And I'm as pissed as you are because they...
I don't think so, dude.
I am. I absolutely
I
am.
I don't fucking think so. Because part of what I'm pissed about is you lost that fucking song I gave you.
I mean, it's something I just have no control over, because that was one thing I...
You don't have any fucking control over. I give you something and you don't load it. That's out of your control.
It's out of my control when I load it and it's not there. And I know I loaded it.
All right, nothing can be done. A show can't be produced. That's the fucking problem. A show cannot be fucking produced. What else is happening out there, Fez?
No Country for Old Men has picked up another award on the way to the Oscars. This one, the Producers Guild Award. So that is just all the trophies going to No Country for Old Men as we go to Oscars. So it makes you wonder, with Oscar night, if we're going to have a writer's strike version and No Country seems to be a lock, is there going to be much of a show there? We're not even going to get the anticipation of who's going to win.
It's like this every year, though.
I still think There Will Be Blood's going to steal it, a la Shakespeare in Love stealing it from, you know, Saving Private Ryan, which was considered the powerhouse.
Who produced Shakespeare in Love?
Miramax.
Mm-hmm.
Great fucking marketers.
Yeah, they will fight for every fucking vote. They're like the Clinton brothers, the Weinstein brothers, and the Clinton brothers. Same thing.
It was the in the ad meter on the Super Bowl commercials. It was the Budweiser Dalmatians trains the Clydesdale to be a beer be part of the beer wagon team that ended up number one on the USA Today ad meter.
Mm-hmm.
At the bottom, it was a Doritos ad where they decided to let some up-and-coming singer get her own 60-second music video on national TV. That ended up last. Did you have a favorite?
No, I watched with the sound down.
Oh, okay.
I was doing the RonFez.net big victory over Pal Talk. So I really don't have a favorite.
I watched a lot of them after I got home, and there just didn't seem to be that much originality anymore. There was nothing that really stuck out.
You know what I love, Earl? First of all, when I look back over, you start searching. The motherfucking thing is still on YouTube. Did you think to go fucking grab that?
Yeah, they got it in the back. They're doing it now.
Yeah. Well, fuck it. It ain't getting on. How's that? Why don't you fucking play a bit from fucking 8 months ago like you were trying to do when I came on? When I fucking came walking back in here. The trade is on, Earl.
So with the ad meter, Budweiser number and Bud Light really wrapping it up. They had like three of the top 10.
Yeah, I could talk about this ad meter thing for the rest of the show. It's great. So give me the whole top 10, Fez. Run it down.
It was number 10 was the Tide to Go. The shirt stain talks on the guy's shirt as he's doing a job interview. Planners, where the son of Peanuts makes an ugly woman seem attractive to men. The Diet Pepsi Max, that had a star-studded cast, and they were basically doing Night at the Roxbury, that old bit. Coca-Cola, it was the Macy's Day Parade balloons going after the balloon Coke. The Bud Light, number 6, men sneaking beer into a wine and cheese party. Number 5, Bud Light, the Bud Light gives you fire-breathing powers. Doritos was number 4, giant rat goes after a guy's bag of chips. Number 3, Bridgestone tires, the squirrel screaming at almost being hit by the car. The FedEx giant carrier pigeons, and then number 1 was Budweiser, the Dalmatian training the Clydesdale. That's how USA Today had it. So none of those seem very good. None of them seem funny.
I don't watch the commercials, really. All I think about is the game.
Senator Arlen Specter, he wants to know why the NFL destroyed the videotape evidence of the New England Patriots cheating scandal.
It's over, Arlen. It doesn't matter. They didn't get anything out of it.
There's
a fucking war on, Arlen Specter. Who gives a shit if somebody was watching somebody else? Here's Mike. Mike, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ron. Love you, Fez. You're sexy bitch. Ron, I'm sorry to tell you, but you know that Opie and Anthony will not take Earl back. They got rid of him once, and they will not take him back. If you tried to give him Fez with him, they wouldn't take him.
Here's Wade. Wade, you're on Fez.
Yes, sir. I was just calling. If he's that bad, why don't you just fire him?
I was told friendship. I wanted to fire Earl last fucking summer, and I was told fucking friendship. In the meantime, I wonder what the fucking friendship is me, because I'm going fucking batty, and I don't even want to talk about it. Read me some more stuff, Fez.
Mike Huckabee was complaining on Saturday that he gets all the God questions in the presidential campaign. And he says that's unfair. But when you're a pastor and you're running for president and you say things like the Constitution needs to be changed for God, aren't you asking for these questions?
Mike, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, I think the people that judge these damn ads are the same people that vote for the movies that you never watched or the Oscars. Because the funniest one by far was Will Ferrell when he was coming up with the catchphrases for Bud Light, and the final one was Bud Light suck one, and they kept cutting them every time.
That came in at number 38.
Here's Rich, you're on Fez.
Hey, you know, there's a writer's strike going on right now. That's why all the commercials suck.
Rob, you're on the Ron Fez show.
Hey, Ronnie. Remember, there is a chance they'll take him back. The Mets took back Bonilla.
You are Bobby Bonilla. Late fucking career, Bobby Bonilla.
Looks like him, too.
Here's Gary. You're on Ronnie Fez.
Hey, Ronnie Fezzy. What y'all doing?
Yeah.
Ron, why don't you just save yourself? Trade yourself out of the show.
I'd do it in a heartbeat. I would fucking do it in a heartbeat. Even after fucking being in here on the air with fucking Aunt yesterday, I'd fucking love to jump in. I look at fucking Norton and go, oh, you lucky bastard. How you do it?
Yeah.
How you do it, Jimmy?
We hope you don't trade yourself, though. I mean...
I'll kill myself. That's what I'm going to do. Well, I'll fucking kill myself. What was that fucking last thing that Earl drove me crazy for like a week ago?
That was the when you were booked on the O&A show.
And then he canceled it without fucking letting me know.
Yeah.
Again, out of his control. Nothing happened to him. Nothing fucking happened. You know why?
Because of what I said, friendship.
Friendship. Johnny O, you're on Ronnie Fez.
Hey, Ronnie. I just, I don't understand where Earl's dignity is. I mean, this happens time and time again. I've been listening to you guys for
a
while.
I don't
want to
get into it, please, sir. None of us have dignity here. Kevin, you're on Ronnie Fez.
Yeah, Earl's a perfect example of why I don't hire friends and family and business, buddy.
Mm. I had to bring a nephew in here and just do this fucking show with him. It's me and my nephew.
Universal, they're doing a new film version of The Wolfman with Benicio Del Toro expected to star in it. Now, could you do a new version of The Wolfman and it still be scary? I mean, it just seems like we've seen The Wolfman a lot. Like, if you did a Frankenstein, I don't, you know, one of those classic monsters, I don't know if that would still be frightening to people.
I don't know if things that need to be frightening or as much as they need to be cool. I think a modern Wolfman with Benicio Del Toro could be cool.
It's the Wolfman Jack story is what it is. It's another biofilm.
Oh, popsicle sticks.
It's Wolfman Jack.
Oh, I thought it was the actual Wolfman.
No.
Oh. All right, I'm an idiot.
No, I just made that up. I never heard any stupid fun. I just thought I'd go for the joke. I'd be one of the guys on this show who tried to make a little joke. Nathan, you're on Ronnie Fez.
Yeah, I got a spy report, buddies.
Love to hear it.
Spy
Black
report.
Black History Month has been changed to Earl is History Month.
So stupid. Did you find that Obama song?
Yes, we have it here.
I'm not playing it now. Not playing it now.
This Friday, I'll be taking on Sam from O&A in the Wrestling Trivia Challenge. It will be the loser having to go around the block here in Manhattan dressed as the old WWE wrestler Goldust in a gold suit and painted completely in gold. I think Sam's a little too confident about this. He may know about the new guys, you know, he may know about MVP or whatever, but when we get into this, I don't think he stands a chance against me. And Johnny Fairplay delegating this thing, moderating it. Coming in with the questions. So that'll be this Friday. Oprah's back on the campaign trail for Obama. She was actually there with Maria Shriver and Caroline Kennedy.
Stevie Wonder, too. She looks good.
Who does?
Oprah looks good to me. I think she's very sexy.
I'll tell you, no matter how you feel about that, it really does make a certain population feel optimistic.
Mm-hmm.
You know? I mean, young people feel a little more optimistic about this. If you've been around for a couple elections, you're like, you know what? I've seen this coming and going. I can't get my heart tied into it. Fred from Brooklyn says he can't believe there wasn't a MafiaLife.com commercial during the big message board game.
Also, Ron and Fez available on audio.com today. Audible.com.
Yeah, I'd want today's show. You know what I'd want to do out of this show? Pay for it. That would be just really fucking strike it home for me.
The commercial that I hated the most yesterday was
the commercials?
Yeah. Was the one with the heart exploding out of the people's chest. Just awful, where your heart decides to quit on you.
James, you're on a Fez.
Hey, just teach Earl how, I could teach Earl how to drive trucks and you'll never have to see him again. He'll take off and he'll be gone.
Thanks.
And he could get laid for $20 at a truck stop, Earl.
All right. Trucks. A lot of fucking truckers today.
With the writer's strike, they said that they're back at the table and hopefully the writer's strike may be over soon. Maybe in time for the Oscars to get a show together. I wonder if that's too short a time, though. The Oscars coming up quick.
What are you going to do? You write two jokes.
Billy Crystal gets a lot of jokes written for him.
Whatever. But the fucking, the show really comes down to who's coming up.
Yeah. But, I mean, they, especially these days, they try and give a witty banter and whatnot.
Never works. Never works. I don't care who's doing it.
I always hate when they have a cartoon, you know, co-hosting or co...
No, I like that.
You like
Mickey,
that?
Mickey, come on out here.
You know it's going to happen this year with The Simpsons or Ratatouille. You're going to see, like, Marge, you know, up there with Philip Seymour Hoffman. It's ridiculous.
Just interacting with each other. They usually give something like that to Tom Hanks. He seems willing to do it.
Tom Hanks will do anything. That's why I love that guy so much.
And this is the first year I haven't heard Billy Crystal saying, you know, they wanted me to host, and yet I had to turn it down. Usually, no matter who they get to host, they have Billy Crystal talk about how he was the first choice.
Right.
He always likes to throw that out there.
I still think Steve Martin was great, and I think he's highly underrated as an Oscar host.
I like the Steve Martin year, too, and they never asked him back.
You guys don't realize that the most popular guy is fucking Billy Crystal. When they write all of those, do all those polls, he gets over like 50% of the favorite of all time, more than like everybody else put together.
I know.
People love him.
But it seems like, you know, Hollywood can't be made fun of because Steve Martin was, you know, kind of, you know, mocking them a little bit, and they turned him down the next year when I thought he got the biggest laughs. Think the guy's great.
In that Billy Crystal vein, I'm surprised Leno hasn't been offered the hosting job.
You would think
Letterman's been there. Stewart's, this is, I think, his second or third time.
Second. Second is second.
Yeah.
Motion carries. But I'm surprised, you know, it's like, that seems like what America would like. It would be a god-awful Oscars, but and Ellen never got asked back.
Who?
Ellen DeGeneres.
Oh, yeah. That was ridiculous.
And she was almost like turning into an MC. You know, like that was her part-time job where, you know, she was doing the Emmys year after year. I think she might have done a Grammys, too.
She did the Suckies.
All right, Jenny Q said that the Obama video is the most star-fucky dreck since Life Aquatic. You don't attack Life Aquatic! And then she has a Kool-Aid thing that just says Go Obama on it, which I don't even get at all. Earl, play the goddamn Obama thing.
All right. And
you got to see the video to make this really work, though. You so you didn't have it. You had it on fucking CD, and you waited all that time.
I didn't wait. I told Pitsy, I was like, run it in.
You know what? Now we're not
fucking.
Shut the fuck up. We're not running it at all. It's fucking all. This is Pitsy's fucking fault. Right?
So the Oscars coming up. Grammys are this week. The Writers Guild not going to pick at that performance, that award ceremony. So I believe that is either tomorrow or Wednesday. See if Amy Winehouse is out of rehab in time to get there.
Guess it's just music.
Now, do they run that show live? Back with the Ron and Fez show, 866-RON-0-FEZ. That's 866-RON-0-FEZ. You can always email us at ronandfez@AOL.com. Now, I will have to get my head shaved sometime this week with the New York Giants defeating, upsetting the New England Patriots in Super Bowl 42. Had the bet with the Z-Man. I sicked the Watley posse on him. And now I still have to get my head shaved. I really thought my betting luck was going to turn around there. I thought maybe the jinx might have been broken.
I think you went against your heart. I think your heart was with the Giants.
Why don't we try to get a hold of Lily?
We'll do.
Lily, of course, she also had a bet on the Super Bowl that she's going to be having to pay off, where she will now be spending a night with Anthony and Melinda.
Sweet Melinda.
I don't know if there'll be a head shaving involved there, but I guess anything could happen. So we'll see how she's feeling today with a New York Giants Super Bowl championship.
I'm sure she's happy, North Jersey.
Who knows? She may be happy she lost this bet.
She was a big Brady fan there.
Oh,
she likes any star. Doesn't matter what the sport or entertainment is, as long as it's a young male star, she loves him. And Brady, that was her guy.
Well, he's basically the football Beckham at this point.
Why don't you give me a little music, would you, Dave?
Oh, I'd love to, actually.
I can't believe that this is probably the highlight of the show today. Give us some music while we're waiting for Lily.
Okay. Just some sweet sounds.
That's everybody. It took a little while, but you got everybody to stop listening.
That was my song called Ocean.
It sounded like an ocean.
Because of the breeze.
Yeah, I picked up the breeze part. It was a breeze blowing over the top of the ocean,
yeah.
But then I kind of heard some rolling waves still.
Yeah, that was the intent.
Mm.
Do you name the song first and then write it? You just want to write something that sounds like the ocean?
Usually. That's how it works, yeah.
You seem to put a little bit more into the titles.
This is Underwater.
Can I think it sounds like a cloud or any air?
Yes, I do, of course.
Mm-hmm. This is so weird. It sounds like Keith Emerson if he had red hair and ate his own shit. All right, they're all gone. Thanks. We had a couple stop back, and then you got rid of them. We will clear the room.
I don't see the problem.
We'll run the station. What I like to do, as soon as O and A are off, we run the station. Just run it until everyone's gone. What's that?
Little air?
Footsteps.
Oh.
Mm. Wow. Where are you walking to anyway? You come back here.
That's how it is.
Just an intern on the things today, Fezzy, since it's that kind of day. Hey, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, what's up, Ronnie?
Yeah.
This is Grandpa Hoo Hoo from White Bag.
Hey, how are you?
I just want to let you know that Dave has made Don Wiki Wicklin one of the happiest men in America today. You now have no listeners.
Oh, fuck.
Sorry about that, Dave. Killed us.
Great call. Just fucking repeating what they just heard. Bobby, you're on a Fez.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Yeah.
Hey, Dave, I was wondering if you can play that old classic, you know, the Mission Impossible theme, the one that every five-year-old learns on the piano.
You know that one, Dave?
No, I don't.
Just give it a try.
Jesus. All right, later, guys.
Oh, wait, let me get into something a little bit.
Into spy mode.
Yeah. No, wait. Bum, bum, bum. Bum, 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 bum.
Here, let me show you how to play the Mission Impossible theme. It's simple. Watch my hands.
Okay.
Now watch.
All right.
See what I do there?
Oh, yeah.
A shift.
Yeah.
So it's like a C to a D?
Yeah,
I can't figure that shit out.
Now this is when I bring up, so it sounds like full orchestration.
That's a lot more complex.
Now watch. Let me just do this one-handed. Coming up.
Okay. Oh,
see? Look at that.
Yeah.
This way, if I have an itch, I've scratched my eye.
It's a G there. Problem hitting those notes.
Coke, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, boys. Hey, I just want to say, no matter how bad Dave is, he's no better or worse than that Mr. Bellamy by Paul McCartney there.
That's out of line, my opinion. I mean, as much as I respect my own skills, you know, the guy's a knight and he's a fucking former Beatle.
He's a hack. He's done with.
Fine. He's a hack. Lip, he's hacky.
He's a knight, but you realize he didn't do any sword fighting or kill a dragon or go into the Crusades, right?
Here's an email to me from Andrea. Jeez, Ron, I can't believe that you didn't realize that they're all scared of you. I did not till today. You're being mean to Fez about the commercials and all that. It's Earl's fault, not Fez. That's what your show reminds me of, like a kid that lives in an abusive home. The way the kids would act if the parents tell them to do something. They get scared and stuttered and do it as fast as they can so they don't get hit. Whatever it is, real or fake, it's sure entertaining. Wow. I've learned a lot about myself today.
I don't think you
I don't agree with Andrea.
I don't think Mr. B needs to change it.
How about this, though? I get fucking annoyed today, so I shut up for a little while because I'm pissed off, so I don't yell.
Right.
That doesn't fucking mean anyone has to stutter through anything. Fez has a fucking bad day. I fucking talk. I swear to God, I fucking get accused of this today over and over for what?
For no good reason. It's really...
Now you sound like the abusive son who's trying to help.
No. I think people's attitudes need to change. And see this show.
You're the one who brought it up. You're the one who brought up the fucking abusive thing.
But no, I didn't say you were abusive.
That's what you said today.
I said the people work in fear.
That's abuse.
No one's getting abused by you. It's everyone else's state of mind. Not Fez, but me, Pitts, and Earl have got to fucking realize this is fucking fun.
It's free money. This is fucking free money for everybody.
And I have fun, but I think other people work out of trepidation and don't see it as fun. It's
Homestar,
like,
what do you think?
You know.